many people are drinking too much coffee and are looking for other herbs to help replace it. So in this video, we'll go over 4 key herbs to replace coffee and help you boost your energy fast. So if you want some good coffee alternatives, then watch this video. Let's go. Coffee beans aren't actually beans. They are technically seeds and are classed as herbs. Yes, coffee is a herb. It's actually the second most traded commodity in the world, only behind petroleum. People today drink coffee for many different reasons. It could be for its taste, its comfort, its weight management, its calmness or feel good factor, the energy, or some people have a physical or psychological dependence or addiction to coffee. But how does coffee actually work? Coffee contains a stimulant called caffeine, which is the main active stimulant within coffee. Caffeine stimulates the central nervous system, which means it speeds up the rate that messengers are traveling between the brain and the body. The average person today takes around 3 cups of coffee per day, and it's said that caffeine in large amounts can contribute to the development of adrenal fatigue. And the symptoms of this include crashes, coffee crashes even, fatigue, stress, brain fog, dips in energy throughout the day, anxiety, and even cravings. That craving for sugar could be stimulated by too much caffeine. And also, some of these symptoms can be seen in people who take herbs in high doses too, so that's something you want to bear in mind, and we'll go over that further on this channel, so make sure you subscribe. So with that being said, let's dive into 4 herbs you can use to help replace coffee. The first herb to help you replace coffee is longjing tea. Longjing tea is essentially a larger green tea leaf, which is very well respected in traditional Chinese medicine. It translates to dragon well, which is one of China's most popular teas. It contains a high amount or high concentration of catechins, and these can increase metabolism within the body and aid in reducing free radicals too. So this is positive for like skin, for aging, and just general wellness. But in terms of stimulation, it has a few stimulants within it too. It has caffeine within it, and it also has theobromine within it. Approximately 40 to 60 mg per cup, which compared to coffee has around 98 per cup. But also there's other active components which can help soothe the body, so it's less intense of a kick than coffee will give you. But it also can help raise your energy level, so you'll feel it, although slower, but for longer throughout the day, you have more of an energy boost without that quick crash that potential coffee can give you. So here is the longjing tea, also known as dragon well. It's quite pricey, but the taste is amazing. And the leaves look like this, larger, look a bit like green tea, but very rich, powerful. Definitely recommend it. The second herb you can use to help replace coffee is guarana. A 17th century missionary noted that members of an Amazon tribe had so much energy when they were hunting that they can go from one day to the next day without eating or feeling hungry. And this is due to this herb that they use to help fuel themselves. And if you go through the Amazon reviews of this herb, you'll notice many people speaking about natural energy, nice boost in energy, a nice boost in focus. So there's definitely something within this herb that's powerful. And one of the key compounds within guarana is caffeine. Guarana actually contains up to 5.8% of caffeine per weight, and that's compared to around 2% within coffee. But it's worth noting that how the body processes the caffeine within coffee and guarana can differ in 3 main ways. For one, guarana contains tannins, and these tannins are calming, and it's said that these tannins can cause the caffeine within guarana to be released much more slowly and give you a longer lasting energy boost. And secondly, it doesn't readily or quickly dissolve in water, which means that its releasing of energy has to be slower compared to coffee, which is readily and quickly absorbed by the body. Thirdly, it contains theobromine, which is also in cacao, which provides a slower energy boost or energy release compared to caffeine. So all of these things combined means you're not likely to get that coffee crash. You're more likely to get a steady, consistent rise in energy and for it to stay there for slightly longer before it starts to wean its way down. It's actually said that the energy boost can last up to 6 hours. So here's the form that I use guarana in. I use it in powder, literally I add it to water, but you can do it in smoothies, juices, and yeah, just be mindful, the energy boost is real. The third herb you can use to replace coffee is rhodiola rosea, and it was used by Russian athletes as a stimulant to help fight fatigue, and it's been promoted today to help increase energy, stamina, strength, mental fatigue, and performance. And it even helps the body adapt to stress due to its adaptogenic benefits. One study found that it can give you a 5-hour energy boost without a crash like coffee, and I personally use this for my workouts for that instant energy boost or something to work out to, whether in tea or in the powder format. Actually, you know, this requires has a video on itself, a benefits of rhodiola rosea video. So if that's something you want to see, comment down below and let me know. Here it is in the form that I take it in the powder, raw, organic, ideally. Literally add this to your water, smoothies, juices, and that's the shot of energy you require for your workouts. Taste is quite sweet, it's quite fine. I recommend it, I like it. Fourth herb to help replace coffee is rooibos tea. I had this in a cafe a few months back and I love the taste. Although it might not boost your energy in the same way, it's beneficial for some of the reasons why people take coffee. And this being concentration and focus, because of its antioxidant effects and its ability to reduce oxidative stress within the body, is said for that reason to aid focus. Essentially, oxidative stress within itself can impair memory or lead to memory impairment, which can impact learning and memory. So those who require a bit more focus, there might be something here for you if that's something you want to do or drink throughout the day. One article on rooibos tea speaks about how it can help improve concentration during exams or stressful situations, and how the compounds within rooibos tea can help reduce the reactive oxygen species and therefore stimulate concentration and focus. And unlike coffee, it doesn't contain any caffeine or tannins, and it's also said to help reduce stress and headaches. So here's the tea. It's quite simple to just steep it in a simple infusion, and the taste is beautiful. It's got a good texture. This one I got is quite fine, but you can get it with slightly bigger leaves too. I think this is definitely a herb to look out for. An honorable mention here, and for this honorable mention, make sure you leave a comment and like down below, smash that like button. But yeah, Siberian ginseng, one of my favorite herbs, also known as eleuthero. Siberian ginseng helps improve circulation and oxygenation of the blood, making it excellent for increasing energy and alertness in general. And also in terms of training, this is a good performance aid to help with delivery time in sense of like delivering nutrients and oxygen to your cells and even removing waste, and also help it with muscle recovery. So this is definitely a powerful herb to keep on your radar. And it also has aerogenic effects within cells, meaning it helps generate energy and activity, as well as helps keeping the body more efficient in its use of fuel. And it has no caffeine too, which is powerful. So here's eleuthero in its pure form. It's literally the bark. I also have the powder too that I add to juices and smoothies. Definitely something I'd recommend. I hope this video has been beneficial for you, and I've got great news. The waitlist for the second cohort of my Herbs for Bodybuilding and Fitness course is open now. So click the description and join the waitlist. It's going to be a powerful, and we're really going to get these gains in. The journey to 100k subscribers continues. Love, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.